Hello everyone, this is Ryan with PC Part Picker, and we're back with another build. This is a special machine for Jack, aka Boy Scout, on our forums. As you can see, he's a big fan of Razer and the black and green color scheme. He's selected a keyboard and mouse from Razer. We're using an i5-6600K Intel Skylake processor, a 650-watt power supply, 16 gigabytes of DDR4 memory, the Kraken X61 CLC cooler, an Asus Z170 motherboard, the special 100 million edition of the GTX 970 from MSI, a 500 gigabyte M.2 SSD, some black and green fans, and the NZXT Razer Edition S340. So let's get started. The motherboard for this build is the Asus Z170 Pro Gaming. We're going to take it out of the box and remove it from the anti-static wrap. To install the CPU into the motherboard, we open up the latch on the socket. Now let's install the CPU into the socket. You'll notice that there is a pin 1 indicator on the corner here, and this lines up with the pin 1 indicator on the socket itself. So we'll set this over and gently put it into place and close the latch. Install the RAM into the motherboard. The first thing you want to do is take a look at your motherboard manual and find out which slots on the board are dual channel. For our board, it's the two black slots or the two gray slots. So you want to open up the latches on the gray slots and then line up the keying on the RAM with the socket. Put it in either side and slide into place. There should be a slight click when the RAM is in the motherboard. This build uses a 500 gigabyte M.2 drive. As you can see, it's 80 millimeters long, and we'll need to install a standoff onto the motherboard before we can secure the drive into the socket. Before we install the motherboard into the case, we need to put the backplate on for the CLC. You'll notice that the bracket has two different spots to line up on the motherboard, and we're going to push these to the inside for socket 1151. Jack has opted to use the Thermaltake black and green ring fans for his build, so we need to remove the stock fans from the S340. Another thing to remember before placing your motherboard into the case is that you need to install the I/O shield. Now we'll gently place the motherboard into the case. Notice on the S340 that there's a post in the middle to help with alignment. Our original plan for this build was to install a BeQuiet Darkrock Pro 3 big air cooler onto the system. Unfortunately, we had issues sourcing it inside of the United States, so we decided to go with the Kraken X61 that we had on hand. The plan with the X61 was to use the Thermaltec ring fans on the outside so that when you looked into the case, you could see this gorgeous green ring, but we ran into some problems. When you place the radiator inside of the case, it doesn't fit. And that's because a 280mm radiator bumps right into the front panel connectors right here. If you have a 240mm, you'll be fine. But for us, we have to put the fans on the case and then connect the radiator afterwards. Now we're going to install the fans and the radiator into the case. So we'll set both of the fans into the front and route the cables behind so they don't interfere with the radiator. Then place the radiator behind the fans. With the radiator in place, we're going to install the CPU block for the X61 onto the motherboard. You'll notice again that there are two holes on this, just like the backplate, and we'll be using the inside ones. Place it down, and then take your screws on top. With the CPU block installed, let's tidy up the cables. We have the power for the pump and the controller software for the Kraken. And our third cable is the fan connector that plugs into the CPU fan header on the motherboard. Before you place the power supply into the case, you need to remove the bracket here that will secure it. Place the bracket on the back of the power supply and screw it in. For easy installation into the case, we're going to plug in all of our power supply cables first. First one is our 24-pin power cable for the CPU. Next, we have our 8-pin CPU cable. Then we'll have two PCIe cables for the graphics card. One SATA power cable for the Kraken. And finally, a Molex connector to control the LEDs that are on the Razer edition of the S340. Now place the power supply into the case. To fit the black and green theme for this build, we made some custom cable extensions, and we're going to plug those in now. Route the 8-pin CPU cable up through the top and plug it in. Then we'll do the 24-pin cable. Now plug in your USB 3 front panel connector to the header on the motherboard. Now we'll plug in the front panel connectors. First one we'll do is the power LED. Then we have the hard drive LED. Finally, the power switch. The last cable to plug in for the front panel is the audio. We also have to plug in the USB header to control the Kraken. Before GPU installation, we have to remove the second and third expansion slots from the back of the case. Next, we'll install the graphics card into the case, but first we'll have to open up the expansion slot latch. Remember to replace the vanity plate for the expansion slots after you install your graphics card. Finally, we'll plug in the power cables for the graphics card. We have one more USB header to install, and this is for our Grid Plus V2. All of our fans are going to be plugged into this, and we're going to control them via software. We're nearing the end of our build here. So let's plug in the LED for the front of the case into the Molex. And the SATA connector that controls the pump into the SATA power connector out from the PSU. The final piece of our build is the NZXT Grid Plus V2 fan controller. We found a nice little spot down here on the side of the power supply that it'll fit. We're going to flip it over so that the power connectors are up and they're more easily accessible and connect all of our fans. The power cable plugs in here and then into a Molex from the power supply. And then we'll plug in the connector from the USB 2 header so that we can control all of our fans. And finally, plug our fans in. And we're all set. Now that we've finished the build, let's turn it on and take a look. Wow, that is a gorgeous looking case, and the fans are just perfect. A big thanks goes out to NZXT for providing us with the Razer branded S340 and the Grid Plus V2 fan controller. If you enjoyed the content or you learned anything, please give us a like or subscribe down below.